So let's break down what we could have at AM2, AM2S, AM2E. Main supply on the left-hand side, TNCS, TNS earthing arrangement, whatever it is. And we've got an MET now. We can see there, metallic water, metallic gas, it might be a metallic structure of the building, offering parallel earth paths. So removing the earthing conductor within a distribution board wouldn't remove those parallel earth paths. So you're going to have to remove it from somewhere else before doing our external earth fault loop impedance. Exactly the same rules apply, turn off the supply, notify people, and all the other stuff that we have to do, but it's removing those parallel earth paths I want to concentrate on in this video. So what we've got now is we've zoomed in to the MET, the main earthing terminal. And you can see there the bottom conductor coming in from the left hand side brings the earth in from the supply source and a single earthing conductor then into the distribution board. And our bonding conductors are on the right hand side, in this case going off to gas and water that are metallic incoming, therefore offering a parallel earth path because they'll be connected to the greater mass of earth being a metallic water pipe and a metallic gas pipe. So you have to remove those parallel earth paths for a true ZE reading. To do that, you disconnect the 16 mil, whatever size it is, earthing conductor, as I've shown there, which is the incoming one from the main supply. With that disconnected, remembering the board needs to be isolated, etc., before disconnecting it, we can now test from the disconnected earthing conductor, possibly 16 mil or greater, to the board itself's individual lines to get our true external earth fault loop impedance. By removing it from the MET, you remove the parallel earth paths created by the metallic water, gas, structure of the building, etc. Let's see that test. I've connected onto my disconnected earthing conductor, an L1, and I would perform my earth fault loop impedance test and remember the reading. I would then move it onto L2 and repeat the test again. Remember, this is at the bottom of the main switch with the board isolated, so it's the only live part within the board. And I would remember that reading. So I'd test between the earthing conductor, L2, as an external earth fault loop impedance. Remember the reading before I move on and test L3. L3 now, my disconnected earthing conductor. Are tested, and I remember the highest of those three readings, and the highest reading would be recorded as my ZE value, my external earth fault loop impedance of this distribution board. And you note all parallel earth paths are removed because the earthing conductor was removed from the MET.